Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will discuss about the clone stamp tool and the pattern stamp tool. So I am selecting the clone stamp tool first, and using this tool we can clone areas of an image. So we have this objects in this image background that we don't want, and we can remove this by cloning this patterns into these areas. So before starting, we will press Ctrl J to duplicate this main layer as we do always. So we have our clone stamp tool selected, and we will press the right square bracket to increase this stamp, and we can select the sample to current layer as we are working only this single layer. So we will clone this part into this area. To do that, let's zoom in first. We will clone this pattern into this area. To do that, we will hold the Alt from the keyboard and click here once, and then you can see we have that pattern into our stamp, and anywhere we go we have that pattern into that stamp. So if we come here, it will show the result of the cloning. So you can click here and drag, that will implement your pattern here. So in this way you can clone that pattern anywhere. So let's do it here as well. Holding Alt, we will click here once, and we will click and drag here, that will remove that object. So in this way you can again hold Alt and click here once and release the buttons and come here and click and drag. So let's see another example into a different image, which is here. So we want to clone this kingfisher into this branch in a new layer. So we will click here for a different layer, and we will also select the sample as all layers, as we will work on multiple layers. So we will decrease the stamp, and we need to sample from this kingfisher. Holding the Alt, we will click here once, and we will get a sample. So now we will find the perfect point to start drawing. I think this is the point, and I will click and start dragging like this, and as you can see we have a plus sign on our template object that is showing from where we are cloning. And you need to keep an eye on both sides to make a perfect cloning. Let's decrease the stamp and zoom in. So now we have to correct this areas. It contains the background from this template object. So we can do that. We will remove these areas using this background. So let's sample from here and drag. And also let's take sample from here. Also we need to correct this shades here. This is too much white here, so we will increase the stamp size and clone from here. I think it's looking nice now. Let's take a sample from here and decrease the branch diameter. In this way, you can clone part of an image into a different layer. So one more thing is the pattern stamp tool. Using this tool, you can draw patterns within an image. So we have selected that tool, and our opacity and flow is set to 50%. And here's the pattern that we selected, and you can select some other patterns if you want. We will create another layer and we will draw this pattern within this white areas. So let's start drawing. So we have our pattern drawn, you can see in this layer, and we don't want to use it like this. We can decrease the opacity from here. And also you can decrease the fill color. I think that's good. So in this way you can apply any pattern within an image. You can use it a lot different ways. I just showed one example. And one more thing that I didn't mention during the cloning, which is the hardness. Currently you can see the hardness is zero, and this is because to clone very softly, that will create very soft edges what we wanted in here. And the most of the cases you will keep it as zero. But in some cases you may need to increase the hardness even to 100 to make harder edges. So that's it. Thanks for watching this video, and hope to see you in the next lesson.